It's official. Dominica's main airport has been renamed.
We have chosen to rename this airport the Douglas Charles Airport.
The airport was renamed in honor of deceased former Prime Ministers Roosevelt Douglas and Pierre Charles for their heroic contributions to Dominica's development.
The two late Prime Ministers whom we are honoring today had to find creative ways of extricating our dear country from financial and economic devastation. It is to them that we owe a debt of gratitude for their contribution, not only for initiating the rehabilitation and expansion of this airport, but also on a wider scale for extricating Dominica from the fiscal pit into which it had been thrown.
Monday's renaming ceremony was attended by His Excellency President of Dominica Charles Savre and Mrs. Savre, former Presidents, Speaker of the House of Assembly, Honorable Alex Boyd Knight, government officials, the members of the Diplomatic Corps, and hundreds of DLP supporters. Honorable Minister for Public Works, Energy and Ports Reuben Blackmore described the event as timely as the nation celebrates its independence.
Being independent doesn't only mean having a flag. It means more than that. It means adopting and showing a sense of ownership to what is ours. And when we name this airport after Roosevelt Douglas, and Pierre Charles, we are developing a sense of pride. That is Dominica.
His Excellency, the President of Dominica, Charles Savre, presented scrolls to representatives of the Douglas and Charles's family. Chief Executive Officer of DASPA, Benoit Badouas, spoke of the contribution of the late Roosevelt Douglas.
Rosie worked tirelessly to educate the people politically, while at the same time listening to and learning from them. The result was that he gained the people's love and admiration. His selfless commitment to the struggle to transform Dominica and the Dominicans, which he led till his own demise, sets example for all future political leaders and citizens.
Rose's sister Joyce Dare says the renaming was a major honor for the Douglas's family.
I would like to thank the government for this gesture, great gesture, and we are honored as a family to be associated with it.
The late Pierre Charles was recognized for his task in transforming the economy of Dominica in the throes of the worst economic recession in nearly 100 years.
Prime Minister Pierre Charles dedicated his life to the cause of Dominica's political independence. And upon becoming Prime Minister of Independent Dominica, tackled the national fiscal and economic crisis of the first decade of the 20th century. Through selfless, thoughtful, and persistent leadership, and for the sacrifice of his own life at the service of the nation, he has gained the love and admiration of the people.
The late Pierre Charles's daughter, Fiza Charles Sylvester, spoke on behalf of the Charles's family.
Many did not see the vision and did not support the decisions of his cabinet. But today, we are all still afloat because of those same decisions.
Honorable Prime Minister Roosevelt Skerritt has defended his administration's decision to rename the airport.
I am adamant that we cannot continue in this day and age to have our main airport named after an 18th century slave owner.
Like a soul, like a soldier, like a soldier. You tied with your boots, them on. Let me hear you sing it. Like a soldier, you tied like a soldier, like a soldier. You tied with you. Continue singing. I want you.